Hello friends, welcome to our digital blogger. Today we are going to review Wisdom Capital. It's a discount broker, part of Ashler Group of Companies in India. In this video, we will be mentioning some of the positives, some of the negatives, and the aspects, the values it provides you as clients. At the same time, so we will be cautioning you on some of the aspects that you need to consider before you go ahead and open an account with them. Let's get started. So this discount broker was launched in the year 2013. The account opening process in this case is absolutely free. You don't need to pay for the demat account. You don't need to pay for the trading account either. And the brokerage charges are very low at the same time. It being a discount broker offers you multiple kinds of plans, and you can see whether you fit into it, where you fit into it, and accordingly you can open an account with them. If we talk about the trading products, we can see it's a very limited range. They can trade in equity, currency, derivatives, commodity, some depository services, but that's pretty much it. We have reviewed, we have compared multiple discount and full service brokers who provide you an array of trading and investment products, but in this particular case, you will have a handful of trading products. If you want to talk about trading platforms, we will go into the detail of each device they are present in. They have some of the memberships of NSE and BSE trading softwares. Unfortunately, they do not have any trading platform of their own. So all of the trading platforms are outsourced through stock exchanges of the country. Let's talk about that one by one in detail. So we are using Google Play Store for reference here. So as we discussed, Wisdom Capital does not have any trading platform of their own. So is the case with their mobile app. They are using NSE mobile trading. They've got a license of it so that they can allow their clients to trade through it. So the app is rated at 4.1. It's a very good rating by around 13,000 users. Around 2,000 of them have rated this app negatively. In a sense, this app is good. It's installed in the range of 1 million to 5 million. The simple reason is that this particular trading app has been provided to a lot of stockbrokers of the country, which are very small in nature, probably medium to level, but not beyond that. So that's why that's the main reason that the number of installs are very high. The last update this app has seen was in June 1, 2016. We are recording this video on the last day of April 2017. So you can imagine that it's around 1 year that this app has seen an update. This app has been developed by Dotex International. So the point is simple. Wisdom Capital do not have any control whatsoever on their mobile app features. So if you are a client or want to be a client of Wisdom Capital, and in case you have some sort of feedback or comment towards the mobile app, they will not be able to do anything about it right away. They might submit their application to NSE to improve that particular functionality or include that particular functionality in the first place, but you won't be able to get the problem fixed right away from them. So simply, they don't really have any control on it. So all the credit of this rating can be given to NSE for maintaining the kind of application they have. Wisdom Capital has very small role to play in this. To talk about other trading platforms, we are using our digitalblogger.com for reference here. So Nest is another formula-based software developed by NSE, and it's been given a license to Wisdom Capital. Then there is BSE Bolt, where you can trade across BSE stocks listed on Bombay Stock Exchange. Again, BSE-based software doesn't have any control whatsoever. NSE, now we've discussed, is that particular mobile app from them. So as you can see, the two, three trading platforms they have, although Nest is a good one as far as performance is concerned, user experience is average to fine, but overall it's a good trading application. But the only concern will always be that you will always be dependent or being kept waiting from NSE or BSE as well, because there is an additional dependency because they have BSE software as well for getting your inputs incorporated onto those trading platforms. So that's one big giveaway that's taken aback by Wisdom Capital for you. So if we move ahead from trading platforms and talk about pricing, now this is one fun part from Wisdom Capital. They don't have any charge whatsoever, neither for the trading account nor for the demat account. For opening account, so you don't have to pay anything. To maintain your account, you need to pay 900 rupees, but that is a one-time cost. This is for lifetime and you don't need to pay anything after that. The brokerage, they've got multiple plans as we discussed initially. The flat one is you need to pay 9 rupees per executed order and you are done. You don't need to pay anything beyond that. And then there are a couple of other plans. Let's discuss those two. So again, back to our digitalblogger.com. So we've discussed this particular one. Then there is a monthly fixed rate plan where you need to pay 999 rupees, around 1,000 rupees, and you can trade for unlimited level, no number of cap on the kind of trades you're placing, the volume of trades you're placing. There is no particular limitation on that. Then in case you can do a longer commitment for a lifetime, you need to pay 10,000 rupees and you're done. You don't need to pay any brokerage whatsoever as long as your capital, Wisdom Capital's client. Then there is another plan called Ultimate Plan where you need to pay a commission of 0.01%. This is most probably for intraday trades. So this is going to be dependent on the kind of trade capital you are placing, and then correspondingly brokerage will be calculated. So it's either you can make a flat rate choice or you can go ahead with a percentage based brokerage plan. Then if you are not interested to pay, you're not interested to trade through the trading platforms, you can use the call and trade facility where you need to pay 20 rupees per executed order, where you need to just call them and tell them that I want to buy this or sell this, and 20 rupees will be deducted as brokerage charges from your overall payment. Or you can give away 500 rupees for the whole month for call and trade facility, and you don't need to pay anything beyond that, and you can trade unlimited level for that particular period. So this is as far as brokerage is concerned. They've got multiple plans, kind of flexible for you, and you can pick out what particular plan suits you accordingly. So the next part is transaction charges. Now people who don't know this, there are other charges involved apart from your brokerage charges or your account opening or maintenance fees. You need to pay this as well, and there is a percentage involved depending on the kind of trading capital you are putting up. For example, for intraday you need to pay 0.00325% of your trading capital. So for example, in case you do a trade of 10,000 rupees, 10,000 will be multiplied by this particular factor, and correspondingly the amount of charge will be added to your overall payment. Then for other segments, these are the percentages that are involved. Now from Wisdom Capital's point of view, and we've done a lot of research in across other stockbrokers of India, these numbers are slightly high. So Wisdom Capital, although is providing you low brokerage when it comes to 9 rupees or 999 rupees or other plans, they have somewhere in a sense they are getting their money through these sort of percentages. There's no standard rate prescribed by any stock exchange or SEBI. So people like Wisdom Capital or other stockbrokers, what they do is they add on these values from their end. They give away that specific percentage to SEBI or BSE, NSE, and then keep the rest for themselves. So that's sort of a hidden charge. You need to talk about it when you are talking to them for opening the account. For example, we will do a small comparison with Zeroda. Let's see how much Zeroda charges for transaction charges for these three, four segments, and then we make a conclusion from there. So this is the Wisdom Capital review page of ourdigitalblogger.com, and we have fixated the screen at transaction charges. So intraday is standard. It's exactly the same across all the stockbrokers, 0.00325%. There's not much of a difference there. Now look at the futures one, 0.00300%. Now let's move to Zeroda and see what they are charging for futures. So for futures segments, you need to scroll down a bit, and you can see that they are charging you 0.0021%, and there is a direct sort of differentiation when it comes to the kind of exchange you are dealing with. So even for BSE, the amount is even smaller. But let's say we are talking about NSE, the amount is 0.0021% versus Wisdom Capital's 0.0030. So there is a difference of around 0.0009%, which is around 30% of differentiation between the two. For delivery, which is going to be the same. For equity options, let's see, 0.0590% for equity options. So for options, it is charging you 0.053%. So Wisdom Capital is charging you higher transaction charges as compared to Zerodha, what you can do is you can check out all the top 3-4 stock brokers you have in the top of your head and compare the transaction charges of Wisdom Capital with those ones. You will be able to figure out by yourself which particular segment they're charging more or charging less. As per our experience and understanding, they are not charging less for sure, but they're charging you more than most of the discount and full service stock brokers when it comes to transaction charges. So in a sense, they are getting their money back in one way or the other. Moving ahead, now let's talk about exposure or leverage. Well, Wisdom Capital is one of those stock brokers that provides you high values of exposure and leverage across the segments. That is, we've done a separate video for that, and Wisdom Capital is part of that video across the trading segments. If you look at these values here, for intraday, it can be as low as 5 times to 40 times. For example, in your case, you have trading account balance of 10,000 rupees, you can trade at intraday for as less as 50,000 to as high as 4 lakh rupees. And it kind of depends on your brokerage plan and the trading history and the kind of pattern you have, the trend you have shown on the stock market. So there are some factors involved, but the exposure values, the range of it is pretty varied, pretty big. So if exposure is one of your preferences, then Wisdom Capital certainly can be your choice. Now let's finally talk about some of the positives and negatives of Wisdom Capital. We have talked about multiple aspects here: trading platforms, pricing or exposure or customer service or things like that, background as well. So finally, if we want to conclude this, we'll talk about the positives first. So exposure, as we just discussed, is high. It's pretty good. You can pick out Wisdom Capital for that particular aspect. Account opening is free, so in case you're looking to make a decision just based on that aspect, which we do not recommend by any means whatsoever. So even if you want to do that, you can go ahead and open an account with them. They will not charge you anything. Some of the negatives of Wisdom Capital. So trading products, we don't see any focus whatsoever on technology. Forget technology, any kind of basic trading platforms is not being developed by them. They were established in the year 2013. We are recording this in 2017. So it's been good 4 years that this particular stock broker has seen in the industry. And it's a good enough time to create one. So why, we don't really know why they are still dependent on NSE or BSE based trading platforms when they could have developed their own ones. Then the customer service, well, that particular aspect is below average to in a sense. So be it quality of communication or the turnaround time or the focus they give you as a client, the customer service across the communication channels is below average. We will not recommend it for that particular aspect. Transaction charges, as we just saw, that they are charging you a lot more than any other discount or full service stock broker, and we are talking about the prominent ones. So even prominent full service and discount stock brokers are not charging you that much as Wisdom Capital is. So in a sense, there are some aspects which are shady and there are areas which are good or average in case of Wisdom Capital. We are digital blogger. We will not be able to recommend you to go ahead and open an account with them because there are some concerns there and a lot of things that need to be improved from there. And once they are good, probably we'll come back with another video or an update of it. And probably by then we will be able to recommend you that. However, in case you want to do that, you want to have a word with them, what you can do is go ahead to this particular link, rdigitalblogger.com/wisdomcapital, open DMAT account. We will be putting out this link and the review links of the stock broker in the description of the video. Put your details, put your preferences, and we will set up a call back for you absolutely free. But in case you want to have a detailed discussion as per your preferences, there is another link we can suggest you. So we are referring rdigitalblogger.com again for reference here. So if you want to pick out specific stock broker, we've got some preferences listed out for you. So you're looking for a short term gain, long term gain, are you looking for tips or not, what kind of software or what kind of facility you want to use for your trading, and some details of yours. So once you provide us these details, we will be able to figure out which particular stock broker matches with you or a kind of stock broker matches with your requirements, and then we will also set up few callbacks for you absolutely free. You can talk to them, get your queries resolved, get your concerns resolved, and then finally you can open an account with them. So this is it for the video. Thank you so much for watching it. We hope you liked it. In case you did, please go and press the thumbs up button. We'll really appreciate it. You can also subscribe to our channel, Our Digital Blogger, at YouTube for similar videos in the future. Thank you so much for watching the video again. Bye bye.